What's going on, everyone? Welcome to the channel. My name's Sagacious, and today we're going to build a new vehicle. I was working on getting my spud gun. I was delivering some of the vegetables that I had grown, but we ran into a bit of an issue, and that is with piston engines in general and a problem that they have. But today we're going to fix that and come up with a new vehicle. I know I should be using a button here, but all I had was a switch. So we package all of our stuff and just getting it loaded up here. Getting ready to make the trip to the trader. Here's where we run into our issue. One of the main things is my vehicle's too light. I should have put more of the weight of the trailer onto the vehicle. But since the axle's in the center of the trailer, all the weight's on the trailer. But really, one of the main problems with piston engines is that they don't have a suspension in most vehicles. In fact, I haven't seen any that use a suspension with the piston axle. Mainly because it's difficult to do. But anyway, because it's a solid axle, it doesn't maintain grip over little bumps very easily. So in this case, I have to put power to the trailer wheels to make it up the hill. It's a bit of a pain, but we eventually make it. All right, let's get this unloaded. All right, so because of those issues, I decided to redesign the vehicle. This thing's all-wheel drive and bearing driven, so it doesn't use any fuel. Super fast and can carry a ton of weight, and because it has a suspension, it doesn't lose traction like the other vehicle. And I'm going to show you how to make this. It's expensive. Here's some of the parts you're going to need. Alright, so Khan just showed this suspension in his recent video with his off-road vehicle, and I noticed that you could use it with a single axle, like a piston engine or a bearing-driven engine, so I figured I'd try to incorporate it into my vehicle. I use it a little bit differently than how he did in his video. Make sure you go check his out, and he shows how to build it. I'm also going to show how to build it here since I use it in my build, but he originally designed it. And I think he even said he got the idea from someone else, honestly. But anyway, here we go. Okay, so we're going to start with the suspension. Just going to place your blocks like this. I'm building this out of all concrete, so it's nice and heavy. It'll make it able to pull more weight. Put your pistons here. Now I actually messed this first part up. Those need to be T pieces and connected together, but I fixed that in a little bit. But anyway, wrap it around here, place your suspension. I need to add blocks to move the lift out of the way. The lift was in my way right there. So I'm going to extend it out so the lift's recentered. So now I have room to put the pipes. mirror this side. Put your curved pieces facing out. Build your pipes out like this, mirroring both sides. And then this curves in. This goes to the back and then up. And then out. Add your bearings. And this should be down. There we go. Weld that all together. And then mirror the other side. Add your bearings again and weld it. Now we can remove these blocks. Those were just for the stand. And there's the suspension. Now we need to make one more. So just repeat this process one more time. Right here, I fix those connections and replace it with T's and weld them together. So that's how it should be. But other than that, it's exactly the same. So just follow the same steps as before. Okay, both suspensions are done. Now we need the three engines and the wheels. Start with a block. That pipe should be a T-pipe. I'll replace that in a second. And then start on the inside. There's no bearing on the inside starting with. So do pipe, bearing, and you're gonna do that 8 times. This is what makes this vehicle as fast as it is, and this is pretty much the max speed you can get to without using an engine. So there's 8 bearings, and then it's a T-piece. And then a final bearing. Another T-piece under here. We need some pistons so it can pass through that block. And we'll take the wheels. We only need 10 wheels, I have extras in here. and make sure these get welded together. Then you're going to use long pipes. Move the lift out of the way. Just recenter it. And like I said, this one should be a T-piece. I replaced that here. And weld these together. So that's how you're going to get power from that wheel back to the other side of the axle. So that first one's done. We're just going to repeat the process two more times. I just added the wheels on the other side. Alright, so those are our three engines. I'm just making sure everything's welded correctly. And that's done. So we have our suspension and engines. Next up, we have to start the body. Now the whole vehicle is going to be cut down the middle, so we're going to leave that gap there just as reference, and later we're going to take that block out. I'm using the motorcycle seat just because it's a block thinner. Okay, so now we have to put the axles on the suspension. So extend a few blocks out. And then weld it on. And then remove those blocks. Those were just to hold it up so you could grab the weld point. Thank you. So just put some blocks down so when you drop it, you can grab the weld point. Like that. And then delete those. And then grab the other suspension and weld it there. And do the same thing with the other wheels. Alright, so that's together. Now we're going to build out the part that's going to connect to the front of the chassis. I'm just trying to think in my head how to do this right now. There's a little experimenting. You need to make sure there's two blocks between the axle and the block above, so that pipe has room to pass through. Okay, so grab the front, mold it on. Now you can break that block in the middle so that the two sides are not connected. That's going to allow the suspension to flex both directions. In a normal vehicle with engines, you don't have to do that since you have independent suspension anyway, but because there's a solid axle, by splitting the car in half, it can flex left and right. Even though it's solid, there's enough bearing so it can bend a little bit. Now we're going to build the front suspension and steering. So these bearings are for steering. I'm just thinking how to do this. Just redesigning this while I'm trying to figure out how to do the front. Just thinking about it. Okay, so this needs to come out. And then down. add some blocks like so. Make sure you kill any attackers. And stay hydrated. Walled on the front. Make sure you increase the suspension levels. These were from when I was balding. I forgot to take them off. Now here I decided to lower the axle one block, just so the whole vehicle will ride a little bit higher. So I just cut each axle off. Raise up one block and then re-weld it. Really easy. So now the frame will ride a little bit higher. And then reattach this side. And do the same thing for this one and the front. I put those blocks on backwards, so I had to fix that. They should have been on this side. But now the lift is in the way. So we just have to move the lift. So I'll weld that back on and fix the other side. Increase the stiffness on the rear suspension. So that's how you can get a nice suspension with solid axles. You could do that with piston drive, but this was much simpler. So now we'll set up the connections. You need a few controllers and two switches. Put one here. I was just thinking about how to do it. So I need one there and one on the front one. Connect the switches. So these, you want to start on the part that doesn't have a bearing. So right here. So this is where the power starts, and it travels to the right, and then is sent back through that bar to the other wheel. Down here. So that's how you want to connect it. Start from the left. 1, 2, 3, 4. And I do the same thing on the rear. I thought I had this one on backwards for a minute. But it was right. So this is going to be 5, 6, 7, 8. So these are going to be, when you press W, only those four are going to go. So that's your first gear. The second four are going to be on the switch, and that's your boost. So that's 1, 2, 3, 4 on the other controller. And the same thing on the rear. And I need two more controllers. And these are going to be the same thing, but for the front. So, from the left. One, two, three, four. And then the other controller. So that's your engine. So I'll switch on that one, and then those two on the seat. So when you hit W, four bearings turn on for each axle, and if you hit the switch, the other four bearings turn on. When I dropped the axle one block lower, I had accidentally moved it back one. So you'll notice here, there's only one space from those blocks into the axle. And there should be two. I fix this a bit later. But notice how I'm one block short. I didn't realize that I had moved it back. So again, I'll fix this later. But the axle should be one block forward. Now we're doing suspension glitch here. This is to help our steering. Going to connect to the back of those, and that's going to help us turn the front end. Those two bearings in the middle for turning, they're not quite strong enough. They don't turn good enough, so that's why we need the suspension glitch. Okay, so all of these are going to be either negative 360 or positive 360, but then you'll just have to flip the rotation on the bearings. and make sure they're on loop and fast. You can reduce the speed a little bit if you have any issues or if it's just too fast for you. Now this one is for the pistons for the rear suspension. So connect the four pistons. I actually grabbed the wrong controller there, but I'll fix that. Set them to one. So I accidentally put those on the wrong one. That's why it wasn't in the list. I just needed to fix that. So there should be all four. And set them all to one. And they can stay on slow or fast, doesn't matter. And that is it. So right here, where I was mentioning I made this one too short. So I cut the front end off and rewelded it. So now there's two blocks from the front of the car to the axle. And that allows the bar on the axle to spin through and not hit the blocks. See right here, there should be a gap of two. All right, and there's your steering. W and S for forward and back. So you can see how the axle spins both wheels. And it's fully independent suspension. Easily take out bots. Get out of here. Yoink. Come on, buddy. There you go. So you can see how both sides can flex over bumps and allows a lot more traction, and so it can go a lot faster. And now this is the rear suspension. You can stiffen it and lift it up and lower it. That's with those pistons. I did a little body work, painted a little bit, but you can kind of do whatever you want. I had to add a bit more concrete just to add a bit more weight. Just make sure you keep the two sides separate. So most piston engines or solid axle builds have trouble with these bumps and things. So this goes over them no problem. So it's a pretty cool solution, I think. Let me know what you think. And if this video was helpful at all, or if you learned anything, go ahead and hit that like button, subscribe. And again, make sure you check out Khan's channel. I mean, if you're watching mine, I'm sure you've seen his videos. But that's where the suspension came from. And it gave me the idea. Next episode, we're going to build a trailer to connect to this. deliver some more vegetables, and get our spud gun. And then we'll probably head into warehouses. See what we can do there. Alright guys, see you all next time. Thanks for watching.